This is the MC Reggie Fresh Morning Show. The station that pays.
Oh, mama, I'm in fear for my life from the long arm of the law. Lawman is putting end to my running and I'm so far from my home.
Oh, mama, I can hear you a-crying. You're so scared and all alone. Hangman is coming down from the gallows and I don't have very long.
He was born from Topeka, Kansas. Went to the high school of Prairie La Compton High. Went to the College of Wichita State. And won 2 Super Bowl rings, Super Bowl 9 and Super Bowl 10, with the 6-time world champs, the Pittsburgh Steelers. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome linebacker number 54, Marv Callum. What's going on, brother Marv? How are you doing?
Man, that's a heck of a build up there for an old guy.
Hey, man, you
appreciate
know,
it, though.
That's the way it is, bro. That's the way it is. Anyway, man, let me ask you this. Was you a Pittsburgh Steeler growing up?
Was I? No, no. I'm originally from Kansas. I was a Chief fan back in the day.
You was a Kansas City Chief fan. All right. You know what? That was, you remember them electronic football games? I think that was one of the first board games they made with the Kansas City Chiefs board on it.
Yeah, we're going back in Lynn Dawson and all them guys back in them days, for sure.
Okay. All right. Well, let me ask you this. What made you want to play football?
Oh, I always enjoyed sports. I come from a real small town. It was actually a farm town. We actually was a 1A. I actually played 8-man football in high school, but I did baseball, basketball, track, and football growing up.
Wow. Wow. So it didn't matter. You could play any position.
Well, I thought I could until I went to college. I was a running back in high school, and I thought I was going to be a running back in college. I didn't realize there was probably 20 other guys on the team that were running back in nurse college. So, no, I kind of bounced, went straight to the defense.
Okay, then. Now, what was the transition for you to go from high school to college?
Well, like I said, I was a small town kid from a small school. We had like 20 kids in my graduating class, which is real small.
Uh-huh.
We only played 8-man football. And then going to college, I was probably the first one to ever get a scholarship to go play football.
Wow.
I didn't really know what to expect.
Oh, okay.
My scholarship was actually track and or football. I was a long jumper back in the days, and I was supposed to go out for track, but I started gaining weight and size, and I no longer could jump as far as I used to.
Wow. Okay, now. You get the call after you graduate from college. You get the call in the draft, and you went to the Pittsburgh Steelers. What are your thoughts, and what were you thinking about?
I thought I'd made the team. I didn't think I had to try out. I actually was a free agent. There was a bunch of us that year in 74 that
made the team
as a free agent.
Okay.
Lionel Taylor was a wide receiver coach, came out and looking for me and some other people, and Dallas was looking for me too. They scouts were out, you know, trying to get us to sign, and he was the first person I seen, and he offered me, I think, $1,500. So, hey, I signed for the first money, right?
Yeah. Okay. All right. That's what's up. Now, let me ask you something. So, what's the difference in pro from college football?
Oh, big difference. High school to college was like a pretty good size step. College to pros is a giant leap, I'd have to call it. It's a lot faster. Everybody's fast. Everybody's good. Everybody's just athletic. It's just you have to catch on fast. and learn quick. It just isn't much time to do that as a rookie.
Wow.
So, yeah, it's a big step, big step.
Okay. Now, I know you was in the Super Bowl. You was in two of them. What was the feeling to be in a Super Bowl surroundings? How did you feel about that?
Well, the first one was 74. That was the first one the Steelers went to.
Right.
Lambert and I was roommates, so we kind of did our own thing the week leading up to it. But that's the year we played the Minnesota Vikings.
Right.
And we just got past the Raiders, so we knew he was going to beat the Vikings. I don't know. We had confidence. I didn't think it was going to be that close to a game. So we weren't really too nervous about it. We were happy to get to there, and we felt like, you know, we're going to win this thing. We don't really realize it, but, you know, we had that feeling.
Wow. Okay, now coming back on that second half of that game, when you got the recovery, you recovered the fumble. What did that make you feel like, and what happened?
Well, it's a secret. Roy Girl, I worked on that all week long, but we didn't want to tell Chuck no because he would have been mad. So I told Roy to make sure he kicks it and acts like he falls down, and I'm going to recover this. And we practiced a little bit on the side and didn't tell anybody, and hey, it worked out that way.
Worked out perfectly. No.
The stories get better every year, right?
Get better every year. All right, now, tell me, what do you think about the Pittsburgh Steelers this season? And if it's any changes that you would make, what would it be?
I don't know. It's any week anybody can beat you. I mean, look at the Browns. They tied them the first week. They're all professionals. They're getting paid a lot of money to make these plays. Steelers, I don't know. It's a defense. I'm kind of surprised it took them that long to start playing better.
Mm-hmm.
It's usually the defense catches on quicker, but they got a solid team. It's just some other teams around them are just as solid, and the play here and the play there, it makes a difference in a game.
Yeah, that's right. Okay, all right. Now, being coached under legendary Chuck Knoll, how was it to be coached by him, and what kind of guy was he to you?
Chuck Knoll was all business. He's a very intelligent man. He said what he had to say. Him and Belichick would have loved and are the same kind of mold. You didn't make no mistakes. You had to do your job. As long as you did your job, the outcome would be good. It's like a team thing. So, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's all, everybody has to be a team player.
Right.
Do your responsibility.
All business.
Yes, sir.
All business. All right, now, let's talk about your second Super Bowl. Was it any different than the first?
Yeah, I'd have to say so. I mean, it kind of seemed like we're going to keep going this thing every year. It seemed kind of easy, you know? We were definitely pumped up for it, too. And, it came down to the last couple plays again. But, you know, we were happy to come away with the win.
Okay. Now, Pittsburgh Steelers as a whole, talking about the whole organization, what do you feel about the organization of the Pittsburgh Steelers?
It's a class act. I was my fourth year, I end up being traded to the St. Louis Cardinals.
Right.
And the difference in the franchises and ownership was night and day, big time. Yes, Mr. Rooney, everybody had respect for him. He put up with the Steelers for a long, long time before they finally got the team grit together. And it's just a class organization. That we do so many charity things together nowadays. I have several charities that I actually do myself with other people. And the guys help each other out. It's just we stay together.
And that's
even after playing season.
That's what you call brotherhood right there. That's what you call brotherhood.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Well, you know, man, I've been a Steeler fan since I was in the second grade, man, and I loved watching them Pittsburgh Steelers. I mean, it was when our team lose, I cry. And, you know, some people...
It seemed like after the first two Super Bowls, there's Steeler nations everywhere. I have Mexico to London to California. I've known a lot of friends all over that.
Hey, we worldwide, man, and we don't back down from nobody. You know, I hate losing. You know, some people like, man, Reggie, it's just the game. I'm like, nah, I don't like losing. Don't nobody want to be on no losing team. I don't care what nobody say. I don't care what you're doing. If you lose all the time, don't nobody want to be on your team.
That's right. And you got to give the Cleveland Brown fans credit because they've been rooting for that team for a long, long time.
And yeah, they kind of. And you took it right out of my mouth, sir. What I was thinking is, I felt like they lose so much they didn't know how to win.
Correct.
You know, when you lose, that's how Detroit Lions was. They were the same way. You know, but I give them credit. They're doing pretty good this year. The Browns are.
Yes, it takes a few guys that, you know, want to get past that stage of losing. I hate to lose. Everybody hates to lose, you know.
Man, what you talking about? Now, what we get ready to do now, Mar, I'm getting ready to ask you a trivia question about the Pittsburgh Steelers, right? Uh-oh. And the thing is, if you get it right, I made a song about the Steelers for Super Bowl 40. I'm going to make sure you get to hear it and sign autographed CD and send it to you.
All right.
It's called Pittsburgh Style, all right?
All right.
So here we go. Could you tell me who this guy is? He was a linebacker. His number was number 54. He went to the College of Wichita State University. He won two Super Bowls, Super Bowl 9 and 10, and he's legendary. Could you tell me who this guy was?
Oh, that'd be number 54 in the program, and number one in your heart, Marv Kellum.
You got it, Brother Marv. I'm going to make sure you get that autographed CD. You got any shout-outs you want to give to anybody?
Just the grandkids. My youngest grandson, there's two of them, 10 and 8.
Okay.
The youngest one, he loves the game of football. It's so funny. They end up winning the grand championship because of him. He's like a little bull.
And they got Steelers stuff too, huh?
Right now he's having fun.
That's what's up.
Yeah, he's having fun. That's what I love to see.
All right, then. Are them the two grandkids in your picture?
Yes, sir. And a little girl.
A little girl and a little. Okay.
Two grandsons and a little daughter. Yes.
Well, that's all right. Any more shout outs?
Be it. The Steeler Nation, baby.
Steeler Nation.
Coming back. You just never know.
That's what I'm talking about. And the last question I want to ask you, Brother Marv, could you please tell me what's the baddest station in the land and the baddest station that pays?
That's an easy one. The MC Reggie Fresh Morning Show.
And you got it, Marv. And there y'all have it. Legendary linebacker number 54 for the Pittsburgh Steelers, Marv Kellum, on the MC Reggie Fresh Morning Show.
This is the MC Reggie Fresh Morning Show. A station that pays.